We'll also look at how tools can improve these software phases, these software activities, and can support software development tasks in general. And this is something that I will repeat over and over in the class. Tools and automation are fundamental in software engineering, and they're fundamental for improving productivity, not only efficiency, but also effectiveness of our activities in the software development process. So let me go back to one of the diagrams that I showed you before. If you remember, we had this qualitative diagram in which we were showing that one of the issues that led to the software crisis was the fact that developers' productivity was not able to keep up with the software size and complexity, with the growth in the importance and complexity of software. What tools can help us to do is to change this and basically move this curve from this original position up here so that it gets closer and closer to what we need to develop the software that we need to build. So let me discuss some examples of how tools can improve productivity. For example, if we're talking about development, think about what kind of improvement was to go from punch cards to modern IDEs. If we're talking about languages, think about how much more productive developers became when going from writing machine code to writing code in high-level languages. And finally, if we talk about debugging, which is a very important and expensive activity, moving from the use of print lines to the use of symbolic debuggers dramatically improve the effectiveness and the efficiency of development. And these are just some of the tools that we will discuss in the rest of the class. And notice that we will also use the tools in practice. So we will use the tools both for our projects and also during the lessons and for assignments. In particular, we will use three main kinds of tools. The first type is IDEs, and I'm pretty sure you're familiar with IDEs. These are integrated development environments, so advanced editors in which you can write, compile, run, and debug, and even test your code. We'll also use version control systems, systems that allow you to save and restore and check the differences between different versions of the code. In particular, we will be working with Git. We will also look at other kinds of tools like coverage and verification tools. These are tools that can help you during testing. And I'm a big fan of these tools, so I'm really going to stress the usefulness of these tools and how you should use them in your development.